Hello friends and welcome to the second part of this video tutorial series on molecular dynamics. In previous video, I have covered an introduction part and strategy to code the multiparticle system. In this second part, I'm going to cover some theory on Coulomb force and we will also discuss some of the examples on Coulomb potential, right? So we will take various examples and we will simulate those systems. So without wasting time, let's start now. So this is the theory for Coulomb force. For a system of n particles, the Coulomb force acting on the ith particle is given by this equation. Here this Fi is the force acting on the ith particle. This Qi is the charge of ith particle and this small r is the distance from the origin, right? Here I am assuming that this constant is equal to 1. As I mentioned in my previous video, I will take all the constant to unity as I am using a normalized unit, right? One more important quantity is potential energy associated to the system. So these two are the expressions for our potential energy. Here basic difference is this dummy index J will run from J greater than I to N, and in this expression J will run from 1 to N, and this 1/2 factor will appear in this second expression. In last video, I have promised that I will show you how to code this potential energy, right? So let's see how to code this potential energy. It is very easy, guys. If you know some basic for loop thing, it just a matter of writing one or two line, right? So in our plot data file, I have written this class named energy, right? And in this class I have written this function named pot. This pot function will calculate potential energy associated to the system, right? So here you can see I have written two for loops. One is for dummy index j here, and one is for dummy index I. Here I is running from 0 to n minus 1 and j is running from I plus 1 to n minus 1. This thing is very is similar to this I is equal to 1 to n, or I runs from 0 to n minus 1, okay? And at the end of this for loop we will have our potential energy. And this function, this is another function. This function follows this strategy, means the second expression. You can see here the second expression. Both I and j are running from 1 to n. So in this for loops, you can see that this I is running from 0 to n minus 1, this j is running from 0 to n minus 1, and here is our 1/2 factor. So this is how you can calculate potential energy of system. Let's focus on our presentation now. So let's take one system. Consider a system of four particles having positive charge. They are placed on the corners of a square and initially at rest. Means they don't have initial velocity, right? Study the motion of such system and also plot the kinetic energy, potential energy and total energy of the system. Now one most important thing, the total energy of the system must be conserved. Means throughout the simulation, total energy must remain constant. Okay. Now before I simulate this system in my code, I want to know from you guys what will happen. Will all these particles just stick to each other, or due to repulsive force they will just fly away? what will happen. So let's find out this answer. Let's open our input file, inputs.txt. We want to simulate four particles, so I am taking n is equal to 4, t max is equal to 5 units of normalized time, and dt is equal to 10 raised to minus 3. Let's run our initial.py file. This will initialize our parameters. This is the list for initial x coordinate. This list is for initial y coordinate. These are the initial velocities, and this is the charge on each particle, this capital Q, right? Let's run this thing. So we have initialized our parameters. Now let's run our main code. In this code, we have our solver, this Beeman solver. Okay, this Beeman's algorithm, right? So let's run this thing. Now, let me comment out this thing first. Yeah, save this thing, okay. Okay, let's run this plot data file and plot this thing. So okay, we are getting this kind of energy profile. This green curve is for potential energy, and this orange curve is for kinetic energy. And luckily, we are getting a constant energy curve, right? So that's good news for us, guys. Means our simulation is correct. Let's animate our data and see what kind of profile we are getting. So this skip 100 data points. This will speed up my animation. Let's hit the enter button and see what we are getting. So due to repulsive force, our system is expanding. And as you can see here, our system is trying to minimize this potential energy and kind of maximize the kinetic energy. So let's jump to the presentation for result and discussion part. So three things we have noticed. Our total energy is remaining constant throughout the simulation. Means our simulation is correct, right? Next is potential energy is decreasing. So as we have expected, due to repulsive force, they will just expand. And due to expansion, potential energy is decreasing, right? And third thing which we notice is kinetic energy is kind of increasing. And it has started from 1, and eventually it is reaching to a saturation point, right? So these are the three things which we have learned from this problem. Let's jump to the second problem now. The second problem states that two oppositely charged particles are placed on x-axis. Initial velocities are as depicted in this image. So as you can see here, we have two oppositely charged particles, and these are the velocity vectors attached to each particle. And we want to study the motion of such system and try to plot all the energy of this system. Now, once again, I want to know from you that what will happen. In this case, we don't have like charges. So there are chances that due to attractive force, this positive and negative part, they will just stick to each other. Or maybe in this case, we have initial kinetic energy or say initial velocity. So maybe they will just fly away. So what do you think? What will happen? Let's find out this answer for this, and open our input text file. So we want to simulate two particles here. So I will change n is equal to 2, and I want to run this thing for 8 units of normalized time. DT is going to same 10 raised to minus 3. And let's comment our first experiment, example 1, and focus on our second problem. So as you can see, this charge is for a positive charge and this minus 1 is for negative charge, and these are the initial position and these two are the initial velocities. Let's run this thing. We have initialized our parameters by running this initial.py, and now I am running our main.py to find out the answer for this problem. Now we want to plot our system, so I am running this plotdata.py file. Okay, so we are getting this kind of a energy profile. Total energy is remaining constant, total kinetic energy is also remaining constant, and total potential energy is also remaining constant. So let's see what kind of animation we are getting. Let's hit the run button. Okay, so they are moving in a circular path, and as all three energies are remaining constant, we can say that our angular momentum is conserved. Now let's shift our focus to result and discussion. So as I said, things are constant. Total energy, kinetic energy, potential energy, all three energies are remaining constant. This is because we don't have any kind of interaction between kinetic energy and potential energy, right? And in this system, the total angular momentum is remaining constant. So this is what we have learned from this system, that they will not stick to each other, but if our initial kinetic energy is in right combination with potential energy, then they will just move in a circular path. Now third complicated example, all things combined. In this example, we have four particles. Two are like particles, and other two are unlike charged particle. So as you can see that here, these vectors are the velocity attached to each charged particle, and we want to study the motion of such system. What will happen in this case? Will they just expand as we have seen in the first example, or due to repulsive force they will just fly away, or due to attractive force as we have unlike particles, unlike charged particle, will they just stick to each other? What will happen? So let's find out answer for this problem. Let's again change our parameters in input.txt file, and we want to run this simulation for 10 seconds, second is the SI unit, right? Initialize our problem. Let's let's run this thing. We have initialized our problem. Let's run the main code to find out the coordinate at each time step. And now our plotting part. Let's see what we are getting. Okay, so we are getting a kind of a spike in kinetic energy and also in potential energy. And good news is our total energy is remaining constant, means this simulation is correct, right? So let's animate this thing. Yeah, so they are kind of moving away. No, they are coming closer to each other. Okay, and let's see what will happen now. Okay, so they are again flying away and trying to move in a circular path. here you have noticed that here is a kind of a blunt corner, right? This is because I am skipping 100 data points. If you want to very smooth curve here, then don't skip that 100 points, this 100 data points, right? But that will slow down your animation. Now let's shift our focus to result and discussion part. So all things are happening here. So due to initial kinetic energy, we have seen that till this peak point arrives, kinetic energy dominates, right? And once we reach the peak point, repulsive force comes into the picture. Here in kinetic energy also, you can notice that after this valley, this potential energy starts to come into the picture and repulsive force dominates, right? So that's why they first come closer to each other due to attractive force, and then as they have reached to a certain point, repulsive force came into the picture and they fly away. Okay, so for exercise and for further analysis, I want you to simulate this for 20 normalized seconds, right? So what you can do is you can go into this inputs.txt file and write 20 here, right? So you will find something amazing. This kind of pattern will repeat itself. And find out answer for that, and let me know in comment section why this pattern repeat itself. Okay, I will post this codes on my GitHub account, so you will easily find out this thing. So this ends our second part, guys. In this part we have discussed theory of a Coulomb force and also discussed some examples related to this Coulomb force. In next part, I will focus on gravitational potential, and we will also simulate some systems. So that's it for today, guys. Hope you guys have enjoyed this lecture. See you guys in next video. Bye.